Hi folks, today I'm at Satok Weekend Market in Kuching. The market is situated in the Kuvaria complex at the bank of the Sarawak River. There is already quite a big and good market here on weekdays, but on weekends, the people from the surrounding villages, even from very far away, come here and turn it into the biggest market of Kuching by far. There are a lot of those giant structures, giant halls here. Two of them are in service during the week, and on the weekend there are a couple more. And even they are not enough, there is lots of the market outside on the streets. So I will not be able to show you everything. I'll try to be quick. I realized I've made a couple very long market videos. I'm trying to make them short, but at the same time I'm trying to show you as much as possible. So I promise this one is gonna be as short as possible. Those weekend markets, usually it's best to come here on Saturday morning. It's really worth getting up early and reserving a couple hours for visiting them. Okay, let's start. Some water apples, really good pineapples, papayas, green cucumbers for salad here, some okra, this is a hibiscus, some pineapples, some eggplants, which are quite similar to our eggplants. They look similar, they taste similar. I think this is a purple sugar apple, not so common around here. Naga or dragon fruit, spaghetti beans, those get up to 1 meter in length. This could be coriander or celery. I would say it's celery. Ferns, they love to make spinach-like vegetables out of ferns. Duku, a local very tasty fruit. Ginger, you will see a lot of different gingers here. Radish, this is their typical Borneo eggplant. They are very proud of it. It's also called like the Sarawak eggplant, sour eggplant, Dayak apple. It, like the name suggests, it's sour, very different taste to the normal eggplant. So if you are in Borneo, don't miss the chance to try this. Most citrus in the tropics don't get really orange on the outside. You need cold weather in most cases for this. Most of them stay kind of greenish, even when they are fully ripe. Avocados here, they are pretty fond of them, however they are quite expensive. Champedak, sweet potatoes, those little mandarins they use as limes. They use them like you get one of them with a lot of dishes to squeeze the juice on top of your dish. So they are very sour mandarins even when they are ripe. Here we have the velvet tamarind, like a dry snack. Asam paya, this is the fruit of the rattan palm. Tampoy, some Baccaurea species. This could be Baccaurea edulis. Cucumber, yes, remember the cucumbers, they have different ones here. Those look like ours, they are being used like ours, but I'll show you other ones too. Judas ear mushrooms, they taste like cartilage, pretty tasty. Some Borneo almonds. Oh, the betel nuts, they like to chew this. It gives you an energy boost, but I think it also gives you cancer. Another type of Baccaurea, another species of Baccaurea, Baccaurea angulata. Those live snails they collect in tidal areas. Garlic and onions, they are pretty fond of those, but they also have other things to get the garlic and onion taste. Some sweet potato leaves, or some relative of the sweet potato, curcuma. Those are shorea nuts, which have already been processed, and this is some related nuts I haven't identified yet. Oh, green pepper, that's so much better than dried pepper. If you find it on the market and if you like pepper, buy this stuff and add it to your food in the restaurant. It's really great. I don't know half of the greenery around here. Sambor, sour, dayak, Borneo eggplant, dragon beets or winged beets. Here is some chopped up bamboo shoots and here's some chopped up jackfruit. Both are used as a vegetable. The jackfruit is still unripe. Some different species of ginger. This could be torch ginger. Some more cucumbers. Still, those are pretty similar to ours. Although, some of those are really small, look like cucamelons, and some of them are even red inside. A small bitter gourd. This is more like a spice, but the bigger ones, they use them more like vegetables. Champedak. Soursop. This is the most common anona around here. Some ginger stems, which are also being used for cooking. Stink nut, this grow, the stink bean. This grows in the jungle on a really huge tree. They don't cultivate it normally, they harvest it from the jungle. And here, when you take the beans out of the pot, that's what they look like. Rambai. Another Bacaurea, Bacaurea motleyana. When you see rambai on the market, the fruit season is almost over. More ferns. Sweet potato. Salak or snake fruit. This is the normal salak you will find in Java or Bali, but here in Borneo, they harvest a lot of other salak species. Let's speed up a little bit. Here we have cassava leaves. They use them as one of their many local types of spinach. Some squid. This is more jackfruit prepared for cooking. Yeah, green jackfruit chopped up and prepared for cooking. This seems to be some taro vegetable. Different types of rice. Most of the rice varieties they grow here are not white, but they have black rice, brown rice, purple rice, darker and lighter varieties. The chance for getting those in a restaurant is not very high. Basically, you'll mostly get the white rice. But if you have the chance to try the other varieties, try them. They have a lot of different tastes. Rich gourd, avocado, this is zapodilla, another gourd, I forgot the name of this one, lots and lots of different vegetables, some for salad, like some are eaten raw, some are eaten cooked, some are just put for a very short time into the stir fry, so they are like half cooked. But unfortunately, I'm not a specialist on their vegetables, more on their fruit. Lemongrass. So they have tons of lemons, but also lemongrass. Unripe ambarella. They prefer it unripe, but they also eat it ripe. Some more fresh green pepper. Oh, what is this? Some different chopped up vegetables. Asampaya comes in two colors, reddish and yellowish. Although the vendors say people prefer to buy the red ones, like with almost everything. Torch ginger buds. They use every part of the ginger here. Oh, here we have some longans. What variety is this? This looks quite similar to the normal longan you can get everywhere, but more, it's more crunchy. Actually, it looks a little bit different from the normal longan. I might come back and try some of this. Tarimakasi. I'm finding so many different longans here. I'm already getting confused. I don't know the names of half of the longans I find here. star fruit. This is still not completely ripe, but already quite edible. Guava, seedless guava, more different guava, more water apple, lemons and limes, lots and lots of different ginger, ginger leaves, whole curcuma plants, ginger stems, peeled and not so much peeled, different ginger roots, those seem to be quite fresh, lime leaves. They add a very nice taste to the to a lot of dishes, but here they don't use them as much as, for example, in Thailand. Here again, the dragon bean or winged bean. Some beans which look more like ours. I haven't seen the cooking cucumbers yet. We are entering the giant banana section. Look at how many different bananas they have. Here, this one little stall sells 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I think even 8 different banana varieties or species. Oh no, 9, 10 different ones if I count it right. Pineapples, 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 lots of pineapples. Well, you cannot only buy the fruit, you can also buy the trees around here. Oh yeah, the giant banana section. Here I made so many banana videos. Different duku varieties. Oops, sorry. Small jackfruit next to small chapedak. More different gingers. Sage. And some other spices and green vegetables. Those bamboo pipes or sections, they use them for cooking stuff. If you had the juggle and have no pot, you can cook all your food inside the bamboo stem. And even in the cities, they sometimes like to do it. Cassava roots. This is basically what you plant the cassava for, not for the leaves. What is this? This is some quite big, either some quite big betel nuts, or maybe this is some other nut. Banana flowers, they also use those for cooking. Bananas, bananas, bananas. For dozens of meters, they are mostly bananas. This seems to be the heart of some small palm, but it also could be bamboo. I guess it's rather bamboo. Yes, I guess it's rather bamboo because sometimes they bring like half a coconut tree and chop it up here as a vegetable. Or also nipa palms and toddy palms, but this time it's just bamboo. The market is so big, so if I want to show you at least most of the stuff, I need to walk a lot. Usually I think, oh, my videos are too long. Yet as soon as I finish the video, I find 10 more different fruit and vegetables I could have shown you. It's always like this. Well, let's try this direction. Giant cooking bananas or plantains. Here they are. They can grow like over half a meter long. Look at them roll right to some other cooking bananas. Those are actually pretty much of average size. Here we have some bigger ones. This is taro. This is some swamp vegetable I don't even know the name of. Pomelos and half ripe umbrella. More limes, more spices. Oh, this is the... No, this is not the garlic leaf. What a pity. I really wanted to show you the garlic leaf too. Yeah, they're really fond of banana flowers, of cooking with them. Stuff starts repeating itself. Torch ginger flowers, torch ginger rhizome. This seems to be our ginger we know from our shops, but it still comes from here. Different rice or cassava roots, some more shorea nut. Oh, here, this is dabai or kembayao, the so-called Borneo olive. You need to heat it before you eat it, and then it tastes like, well, like olive or avocado. Nobody says you can only sell bananas in the banana section. This one sells beautiful rocks. Oh, here a breadfruit. The market goes on forever and forever, so I could show you a lot more sections like this, but I think this is the section with the most fruit and vegetables. If I make the video like 1 hour, I might find 10 or even 20 more interesting fruit and vegetables, but I think I'll finish here and try to go and buy some interesting stuff. So folks, stay tuned for more fruit videos from the jungles and markets of Borneo. And if you want to support the channel, please watch the videos, leave a nice comment, subscribe, and share the link.